Before proceeding, please make sure to subscribe and turn on the bell icon for upcoming videos. In this video, we will look at the development of the face. Before moving on to this video, please watch my previous videos on the basics of embryology and pharyngeal arches to have a much clearer concept on today's topic. The development of the face begins at early week 4 by the formation of certain facial prominences at the head region of the embryo, with the frontal prominence being the first one to be formed. Here will be the stromodium, the optic vesicle, which will become the future eye of the baby, and the cardiac bulge. And also, the 5 pairs of the pharyngeal arches which are seen just above the cardiac bulge and lateral to the stromodium. By the end of the week 4, localized ectodermal thickenings appear on the lateral sides of the frontal prominence. These localized thickenings are called the nasal placards. At this point, the first pharyngeal arch will develop another prominence called the maxillary prominence, and the part of the first arch itself is now called the mandibular prominence. Now let's turn this embryo towards the right and have a frontal or ventral view of the nasal placards, the maxillary prominence, and the mandibular prominence. The part of the frontal prominence present in between the nasal placards is now called the frontonasal prominence. Please note that the prominences are also called the processes. The buccopharyngeal membrane, which was present between the stromodium and the foregut, disintegrates now and the stromodium becomes continuous with the foregut. As the embryo enters into its 5th week, the underlying ectomesenchyme surrounding these placards rapidly proliferates and produces a ridge surrounding these placards. This converts the nasal placards into the nasal pits. The bulging of the tissue at the medial sides of these nasal pits are called medial nasal processes, and at its lateral sides are called the lateral nasal processes. The frontonasal prominence along with the medial nasal prominence will give rise to the middle portion of the nose, the upper lip, and the primary palate. As the 6th week arises, the maxillary processes on both sides will grow towards each other, which results in the approximation of the nasal processes on both sides. But the processes remain separated from each other by certain grooves, which are the nasooptic groove separating the maxillary process from the lateral nasal process, and the buccal-nasal groove, which separates the maxillary process from the medial nasal process. The external ear nodules are also seen at first pharyngeal cleft by this time. At week 7 to 8, the lateral nasal processes fuses with the maxillary processes to form the lateral sides of the nose and the lips. And the fusion between the medial nasal processes along with the frontal nasal process causes the formation of the middle portion of the nose, the philtrum, the upper lip, and the primary palate. The lower lip will be formed by the fusion of the two mandibular processes. And this will be the location of the fused processes on an adult face. If you think this video was helpful, give a thumbs up and subscribe my channel. If you have got any questions or suggestions, please write them down in the comment box. And don't forget to turn on the bell icon for upcoming videos. Thank you for watching.